I think that we have, with a couple of things that have happened the last 20 years, we have self-destroyed the Western respectability, influence, and legitimacy. One has to do with the response to 9/11, where the Americans have since then had the global war on terror, which has cost millions of people their lives, and terrorism has not been combated. I mean, it's not over with terrorism, as we have seen. Secondly, it has been the reaction to the Ukraine invasion, which I find totally illegitimate and foolish to do. But I also understand why NATO's expansion into Ukraine for 30 years. That was a very destructive thing from the Russian point of view. And so what we did in Europe was to install these sanctions, which are now coming back negative. Now, third, the blowing up of Nord Stream, which is destroying the economy, and everybody knows who did it. It's just not public. Now, everybody seems to say it must be somebody else because the Americans said they would do it. I mean, this is ridiculous. And it's the largest destruction of infrastructure in modern times, as far as I know. Finally, Gaza. Madame von der Leyen went out and said the day after October 7, on the same day, that we Europeans stand by Israel. Well, how long time do you do that? 23,000 people have now been killed, 55,000 people wounded, and tons of UN staff and journalists, media people have been killed. And this whole infrastructure is destroyed. Houses are destroyed. Water systems are destroyed. Electricity system. It's a systematic effort of getting people to leave. Now it has lasted for soon 3 months, and it has not stopped. And the Americans have prevented a ceasefire, and also continues to deliver weapons to Israel. Now, my point is, to make it short, 85% of the world sees what those 15% Westerners, NATO, EU, the US countries are doing, and they will turn their back to the West. That's one of my predictions. And of course, this has to do not with anybody threatening the West. The points I gave you now are all points where we have reacted to something that happened or to events in the world in the wrong way, in a panicking, non-analytical way, and not anchored in a democratic decision-making. And one other prediction I do is, and I've done that before, is we will militarize ourselves to death, exactly like the Soviet Union did in the 70s and 80s and fell apart in 1991. We're now having a standard reflex or gut reaction to anything that happens, which is we need more weapons, more ammunition. I mean, look at that. You pump in more weapons, more and more weapons until Ukraine is totally destroyed. You pump in weapons now to the Nordic areas, maybe that will be destroyed at some point. You pump in weapons to Israel to be even more superior than they are already as a nuclear power, too. So we don't do diplomacy anymore, but that will drag on in the sense also that there will not be an agreement. There will not be peace among between the Ukrainians and Russians. There will not be a solution to what we do, and rebuilding Ukraine will take decades. And as I predict, also Russia is not coming back to Europe for decades ahead. The way we have treated it's much worse than the old Iron Curtain. You can hardly go there anymore. We're not supposed to have anything to do with them. And piano concerts or whatever, cultural houses, other totally civilian relations are already cut down, and no trade and all this. And I think we are having already a serious economic crisis all over Europe. And it'll be worse because we've cut off all relations with Russia, which was a major deliverer of, for instance, energy and a major, partner in industry and trade and investments. As you may know, where BMW were produced in parts of Russia, it's now Chinese cars that are produced. Just go to RT.com, Russia Today, you'll see how Russia, point after point, is turning away from Europe. So, I mean, why should the Russians sit and wait for the Europeans to come to their senses? Russia can turn around and work with India and with China and with Iran and the Middle East and Africa instead. I mean, the world is big. And it's time the Western world finds out that you know, we're not the only ones that are attractive. As for Gaza, I think it'll take, and that's according to both Western military analysts, analytics, and Israeli statements, that this will take years. And secondly, it will have repercussions throughout the Middle East. I mean, this is already spreading. Israel is now bombing in Syria and in Lebanon. We don't know what happened a couple of days yesterday, or whenever it was, in Iran, around the close to the memorial of Soleimani. And you will have the Houthis, you will have transport lanes involved, you will have what may end up in a larger war in the Middle East. I'm again saying I hope I'm wrong, but this is not going, in my view, to stay as a localized thing between Israel and Palestine, and for that matter, also with Hamas. We have got to, you know, think of a road towards peace in that area, and that takes years. Negotiate it step by step, meticulously, finding out how could people live together in that area, but not with apartheid, not with genocide, not with racism, and of course not with a government that is a military organization, et cetera, et cetera. I mean, again, my point is, and I can use it everywhere in the world, weapons make things worse. And weapons and militarism is based on anti-intellectualism and intellectual and moral disarmament. In the short run, it's going to be very bad. And then in the long run, we will have a new world order with multipolar cooperation. We will have much less weaponry, because the structure of one trying to dominate the rest will automatically create militarism. Whereas if you have a network of, let's say, 5 or 10 poles, and then people relating in terms of, like, the Belt and Road Initiative, cooperating instead of confrontation and all that, you also reduce the risk of warfare and the need for the perceived need for weapons. So I'm an optimist, you know, 5 or 7 years ahead from now, when the Western dominance has declined and fallen completely. But I have to also be honest and say I don't know how it will fall. I have predicted 40 years ago that it would. With the Soviet Union gone, the West and NATO will also go at some point.